A warm good evening to all. We are all here on the national webinar of Sahya Arts and Science College, Vandoor. Immersion 2K20, Episode 2, Nudge in Daily Life. Well, since everyone is here, we should get started. Hello everyone, it's Amrita Kumaran, HOD Department of Computer Application. Heartily welcomes you all for the second episode of the national webinar of Sahya Arts and Science College. I would like to speak a few words on our college. Sahya Arts and Science College was established in 2013 under the aegis of Sahya Tourism and Pravasi Cooperative Society Limited. We are committed to develop the life skills, knowledge and the right attitude to the students with continual improvement through dedicated teamwork. And also I would like to speak about our webinar. Mainly this session, it aims to discuss the presence and the role of nudges in our daily life. Our college organizes national webinar series in the coming days. Here are the list of various series. We are on the series 2. Next is going to be conducted series 3, which is going to be organized by Department of Finance on the topic Glimpses of GST on 25th August 2020 at 10:30 a.m. The session is going to be handled by Dr. Sindhu B, Assistant Professor and Research Supervisor, Pavanatma College, Murikkasheri, Idukki. Series 4, which is going to be organized by Psychology Department on a topic Intimate Partner Violence and Overview on 5th September 2020. The resource person is Shyam Ravindran. He is a clinical psychologist, Manipal Academy of Higher Education, Kasturba Medical College, Manipal. Series number 5, going to be organized by Department of Economics on a topic Socioeconomic Impact of Lockdown in Kerala Economy on 7th September 2020. The resource person is Dr. P. Naufal, Head Department of Economics, Dr. B. R. Ambedkar Memorial Arts and Science College, Balasheri, Kozhikode. Series 6, going to be organized by Department of English on a topic Developing Transferable Skills in English Language Classroom on 9th September 2020. Resource person Dr. Babu, former principal, MES Mambad College, and Dr. Firoz, Sharjah University, UAE. 7th series going to be conducted by Department of Corporation on a topic E-filing of Income Tax Returns on 12th September 2020. By the resource person Dr. Abbas Vattoli, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce and Management Studies, Amal College of Advanced Studies. The last series, series number 8, going to be organized by Department of Chemistry on the topic Ozone Day Observation on 16th September 2020 by the resource person Dr. Meher Alminath, Assistant Professor, MES Mambad College. Once again, good evening to one and all. It's my pleasure to welcome our management members of Sahya Arts and Science College and the most beloved principal, Professor Thomas Matthew, and our vice principal and head of PG Department of Commerce and Management Studies, Dr. A. Sudhakaran, and all the participants from different disciplines who are on live with us. And now, I would like to extend a warm welcome to a guest of honor, Dr. Vineet K.M., Assistant Professor and Research Supervisor, PG Department of Commerce, Government College, Trippanuthura, Ernakulam. We are so excited to have you all here to participate in our national webinar, Episode 2, which is organized by PG Department of Commerce and Management Studies in association with IQAC. I hope that today you will get a very informative and effective session that can be made use of it. And now, it's time to hand over this session to Dr. Vineet sir. Before that, I would like to speak a few words on him. Dr. Vineet K.M., Assistant Professor and Research Supervisor, PG Department of Commerce, Government College, Trippanuthura. He is also a life member in Indian Accounting Association, a patron in Indian Institute of Scientific Heritage, and also a peer reviewer in different journals. So today, this evening, we are very grateful to have him with us and he will be handling the section Immersion 2K20 Episode 2 on a topic Nudge in Daily Life. So it's time to welcome him. So welcome yourself.
Thank you, Amrita, and the organizers for this opportunity. And thank you, Nasia of KMM College, for the lead which made Amrita to contact me on this particular webinar. And let's we go on with the topic. When Amrita asked me on which topic you would you like to talk, I said, let it be something new, or let it be something that there is a gap. There is an understanding gap of nudge. So that itself is the importance of this particular topic. We are in front of too many nudges, and we would like to know more about it. It's a very good area of research, and we are going to understand what nudges and how we are influenced by different nudges. So let me present my screen now, and I request Amrita to make sure that nobody is presenting in between, and if the presentation is disturbed, please let me know, because I will not be seeing the chat window.
I request all the participants to please mute your phones and please turn off your cameras.
So Amrita, is it visible?
No, sir.
Hello? It is
no,
visible.
Sir.
It is no, not.
Sir. No.
Is it coming?
No, sir.
It is shown to me that it is shared. That's what.
Yes, sir. It's already seen, sir. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah. Carry on.
Okay, fine. So thank you once again for the opportunity, and let's discuss a very important theory in behavioral economics called nudge. A very interesting area, a very widely used area in marketing than finance. Even though it was created in marketing, it is applied more in, sorry, it is developed in finance, but we applied more in marketing. But what happens to our peripheral understanding is also like that. We are too much concerned about our specializations. Once you start learning finance, you try to stick on with finance alone. Once you learn marketing, you stick on with marketing alone. But knowledge is always multidisciplinary, or at least interdisciplinary. So we should break our shells to understand what is happening and what are the applicabilities of the different theories. That is possible only when you learn international literature. But when we normally read the small level, the bottom level literature, what happens is we become more and more like eggs within the shells. We are not going out of it. So let's go out of the shells and understand the concept of nudges. And why I talk about this and how I came to know about this is what I will be specifying now. This is the person behind, Richard Thaler, a Nobel laureate in 2017 in economic sciences. And the students of commerce and management, please understand that there is no Nobel Prize in commerce or management. It is in economic sciences. So please understand that is our parent discipline. And please don't underestimate the depth of economic theory. The economic sciences is identified and given this privilege. And he belongs to University of Chicago, a very funny person. I have watched this interview, and the celebration happened in University of Chicago. It was in YouTube live, and I watched that meeting immediately after the award of the Nobel laureate to him. And he was very funnily presenting the concepts, his ways, and also the backstabs he got in this career. So it's a very interesting fellow. Please search about him, please read about him, and let's go. What is more? And he says, when an economist says the evidence is mixed, he or she means that the theory says one thing, that data says the opposite. So that is how the international literature sometimes goes. And he says that is when we place the column that it is mixed, our response is mixed, means we wanted to prove it one way, but the thing is going the other way. So this can happen. And that is, we are not always rational. That's a basic. You cannot rationally explain why some things happen. Not always. You can explain to an extent, but not always. Even the best possible person in your life might have hurted you sometimes. Even the best possible lover or the person whom you love too much might have acted in a way that you hate him, at least for an instance. So we cannot explain why it happens. It happens in economics also, economic decision making also. And that is where we talk about that. So what is nudge? A nudge is a small feature of the environment that attracts our attention and alters our behavior. It's a very small feature. It may be a willfully created. Normally we willfully create it. And that will attract our attention and alters our behavior in a favorable, desirable action, that I would say. To in addition to that, is what I say is in a favorable action. So let's go to the definition. When we learn literature, we need definitions. So nudge is a concept in behavioral economics, political theory, and behavioral sciences. See the discipline, the variety of disciplines, which proposes positive reinforcement and indirect suggestions as ways to influence the behavior and decision-making of groups or individuals. Let's take an example. We have seen the, you might have seen the first slide. This is the image taken from the cover. The book is Nudge, Improving Decisions About Health, Wealth and Happiness by Taylor and Sunstein. And the image of the elephant, the baby elephant and the mother elephant is used in Nudge. How they communicate? That is why that image is used. The mother elephant communicates to the baby elephant with a gentle push normally. And you might have viewed videos in YouTube or otherwise how a baby, an elephant baby is born. Baby elephant is born. And there is no doctor or nurse to make the preliminary cure. It is done by the mother itself. And normally it is done by, sometimes it is done by heavy kicks like a football and some nudges, a gentle push also. And it communicates. Through which it communicates and the baby understands. And baby acts on a favorable direction. What the mother elephant is communicating is properly getting into the brain of the baby elephant. Same way, if you can force a person or influence a person, not really forcing, it is not enforcement, it is not compliance, it is not education, it is not legislation. You are simply influencing a person to do something. Why don't we do this thing? If your teacher tells you that a conference is coming, why don't we present a paper? I can help you. It's a very positive nudge. Negative nudge may also be there. If you don't score this many marks, I will be scolding you or I'll beat you. That kind of negative nudges can also happen. But Taylor talks always about positive nudges. It can call be a nudge only when it is positive. That is why we say good nudges. So nudging contrasts with the other ways of compliance, education, legislation or enforcement. It is not that. We are not going legal. We are not going what you call technical. But we are going very much emotional. We are attracted towards the emotional part of the brain and why it should function. Rationality is always in question here. One way to think about is that the automatic system of your gut reaction. Normally, when you are given a question, you will have a first answer. That is your gut answer, GUT. That is your gut answer. But the rational answer comes next. You will be thinking about the outcomes, prospects and consequences, and the next level of answer will come next. Normally, I'm taking about the word. But the first answer is always based on the automatic system. And some people recommend, and even you know, you are very familiar to the catchword, just do it. Trust the gut. These kind of words are very much famous. Because sometimes the emotional content works better than the rational content. But the pace with which it works itself is the question. And let's see a small example. Please either note it down or keep it in your mind. I will be giving you three questions. Note down your first answers. Please don't think too much. Please don't write equations to solve it. Please don't think too much. Just hint your first answer. And you need not tell me at all. Just keep it with you. Okay, I'll be giving you 1 minute each for those questions. Okay, three simple questions. A bat and ball cost $1.10 in total. A bat costs $1 than the ball. Then how much does the ball cost? Same way, if five machines in 5 minutes make 5 widgets, how long it will take for 100 machines to make 100 widgets? Third question, in a lake, there is a situation that the lily pads get doubled each day, and in 48 days, the patch is covered 100%, then how many days it will take to cover 50%? Three questions. Just think of your first answer, not the best answer. Keep aside your ego, keep aside your bounded rationalities or even rational. I'm not looking into the chat box because I have already told you. You just keep it with you. You need not share. It is for your own thought. It is from that book. This example is directly from that book. The book on Nudge. So you have three answers with you. Whether right or wrong, there is no issue with that. These are the most common answers. The ball would be costing 10 cents. The machine would take 100 minutes and 24 days. The first answer you might get, then normally we call it the immediate wrong answers. These are the correct answers. The intellectuals might have got it. Those who think too much might have got the correct answers. This is what you normally call it as your automatic system and the reflexive system. The correct answers come from the reflective system. The other answers come from the automatic system. Which one to go is your decision. That is normally, it is taken by the people. Sometimes the automatic system works. Sometimes the reflective system works. And that is where we say we are normal. We are not rational. We are normal. Because in basic economics theory, we have the theory. The man is rational. The rational economic man theory. But normally, we are normal. We are normal that we might make mistakes. It is good that you are normal and you make a mistake. But you are not expected to make the mistake always. That's the only thing. So humans sometimes go with the answer the lizard inside is giving you without pausing to think. you might go with that immediate impulse which leads you to the decision. That is the basic theory. Now, consider this. You have an investment opportunity. There is a guaranteed return of rupees 500. And another opportunity tells you a 50% chance of winning 1,000 and a 50% chance of winning nothing. Which one would you choose? You may post your answers in the chat box. Option A or option B? Please post your answers in the chat box. Would you go for option A or option B?
Sir, we can't hear you. I think your mic is muted.
Mic.
Hello. Yes, sir. Now it's audible.
Somebody accidentally muted me.
Yes, sir. Now it's audible.
Yes. So the anchoring bias happens regarding this. What happens is you say a price, I said the example that I told you was 2000 rupees was given, struck off and given it as 1500, and you will be anchored about that 2000. You will not be thinking about that 1500, you will be thinking about that 2000. 2000 rupees worth of product is given to me for 1500. So that kind of anchoring happens. You, when you compare also, the anchors are used. You compare it with some anchors, compared productions, products. Product comparisons in e-commerce websites are given with anchors. So these kind of things happen with biases. Please read. I would request all the commerce and economics students and management students, please read the book and understand these biases. It's a very beautiful area to do research projects, especially your UG and PG and even PhD projects. So what is nudge here? In the book, they say the incentives, the understanding of mappings, the defaults, the giving of feedback, the expectation of errors, and the structuring of complex choices makes you nudge, the best nudge. We will have examples on this. Then only we will understand why. So, first aspect is giving incentives. Giving incentives means, normally even to small children, we give incentives, right? That normal, the most common incentive that you give to your kids. Like that, nudge is there. From that, there is nudge. So, this is done in marketing also. If you buy this one, you will get this free. It's an incentive. Then, understanding the mappings. Understanding the mappings happens where? Why it happens? Like, you have to understand why a person thinks in a particular fashion. And make him or her to think in a particular fashion. The brain mapping is done. That is understanding the mappings. Then, there are defaults. Default means if you don't choose something, this will happen. You'll understand that better, I think, because there is a default option and there is a custom option in almost every software that you download and install. The basic option or a default option, and there is a customized option. Very rarely people go for customizing because people are not really tech savvy. And when they are not really tech savvy, they don't go for customization. They choose the default. This happens with your normal decision making also. If your financial advisor is not telling you the details or the customizing possibilities of your product, it may be a mutual fund, it may be a unit linked insurance policy, it may be a rider, insurance rider, whatever. If the person is not telling you the possibilities of the additional customizations, you are going with the defaults. So there is a basic tendency to go with the defaults. We are passive. We are passive more than active. We pretend to be active, but when it comes to decision making, we are more passive. These are the theories, the internationally accepted psychological theories. And somebody in my knowledge, who is a research supervisor in commerce, asked me why you are recommending a PhD thesis in commerce in behavioral finance topic. And she says the behavioral finance is a psychological topic. I agreed with her. Yes, it is related to psychology. But I asked one question back. Consumer behavior, is it marketing or psychology? That is marketing. That was the answer. So that is where you take four defaults. Something you accept and something you reject, but all are to be taken. Commerce is a very acceptive, very receptive area, which we accept almost anything. We commerce teachers can teach even Arabic. That is how my friends were mocking me when I was at working with Palakkad. And that is, we commerce people can understand almost any topic. We intake almost everything. When artificial intelligence is coming in, and we are taking in those papers also in our VCOM restructuring paper. You just wait. Next edition of restructuring in VCOM, you will have artificial intelligence. Data analytics is already taken by modern universities. Have already taken data analytics in BCom curriculum. So this kind of things happen. Default is there. We have a bias. We are biased towards the defaults. Fourth is giving feedback. You give a feedback. Yes, good. You did a good job. Yes, you did a very good job. That kind of a pat is there when you nudge it. Then you should also expect some sort of errors from the parties, because you cannot always expect people to do on a regular scale. I'm not showing any videos or that kind of things here, but you are very familiar with a WhatsApp video, very shared by the training people. A person was asked to climb on a chair, and he was told to close his eyes, and he was told that he should just fall down slowly, his colleagues will pick him up. And everybody were arranged in the back corner, and this fellow fall down into the front area. This is the problem with error. You should expect errors. The nudges need not always work in the perfect fashion. You should also always expect errors. And you should be structuring the complex action to the best possible alternative. We will have an example on this, especially to which we always very much know and very much interested. That is, food. How can you structure your food? Example from Google is there in the nudge story. And these stories are not my stories. These are taken from the web references. There are too many articles in the internet regarding these nudge examples. Okay, so let's move. These are the nudges given from the book. And I request, I am always a very, not that a lenient teacher. I am sometimes a very strict teacher. So I will explain
Sir,
the first one.
The screen is not visible.
That
Can
is because
share
somebody.
The PPT?
That is because somebody else presented.
Hello, Amrita. Yeah, now it's visible.
Somebody else is interrupting. That is why.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yes, it's visible, sir.
Yes. So again, in this example also, I will explain the first one, and I'm giving you the rest for your reading, because it is directly in that book. That is why I'm not explaining it. The number one example is give more tomorrow. That is actually a trademarked practice by Taylor. It's a package like a pension plan. It is you're advising a person to invest a very small amount today and increase your investment day by day or month by month or year by year, thereby get a beautiful pension plan. And normally when people sell insurance policies, they are connecting with the monthly premium and the sum assured. For example, they say invest 1,000 per month for 5 years and get 75,000 rupees at the end of 5 years. Or that is a handsome amount. Let me get into something reduced. 65,000 rupees sum assured at the end of 5 years. So 1,000 rupees investment, you are getting 65,000. That is the way normally usual life insurance people market. But thinking about LIC premiums, that is where we also argued with LIC, the regional managers recently. And when you multiply the premium value and sum it up, it comes to 60,000. And 60,000 is growing to 65,000. It is nothing for 5 years. So that is not a real compounding. Sometimes if you really calculate the terminal values of policies or the sum assured of policies, you will be disappointed because it is not growing as much as it is expected to be. So the give more policy tomorrow, this works well, but it can be creative in a way that you contribute a small amount today, a better amount tomorrow, later that you get a pension plan. But it is better because something is better than nothing. Pension plan is always good when there is in a country where there is social security is an issue. Okay, so please go through these examples. I'm giving it to you. It is directly in that book, and in the WhatsApp group, I'll be sharing that book also, even though it is copyright violation. Yeah, better you just download it by Google itself. Just nudge colon PDF. You will get that book. These examples are there. So I'm not explaining these. These are the points that I'm going to explain, that is nudge in daily life. How you face it in your daily life? Number one is upselling. When you order a set of idli or dosha at a restaurant, normally in the South Indian restaurant, they will nudge you with a vada. Is there any problem? So normally, in upselling, it is a classic example. This happens in your new generation McDonald's also. Would you like an extra large fries with that? With that question, 100% out of 100, 80 to 90% say yes, unless your budget is too much affected, and your ego will also be affected. That if you say I don't want it, the other fellow might feel that I don't have enough money. So that kind of thing is really happening in upselling. It is a real classic example of nudge in your life. Nobody would have escaped from this nudge, especially the vada example with the idli or dosa. Then the product placements, the way in which the products are placed. In a Tamil movie, Fahad Fasil was explaining it very, very well. How the supermarket arranges the items. The basic necessities like rice and etc. will be hidden in the way end of the showroom. And you will be nudged towards all the brands in your way to the basic necessities. Same way, as you come to the billing counter, the most important nudge, that is the pester power. If you are going with your children, you will be forced to buy some chocolates. And the chocolates will be very close to the cash counter. And this is called as pester, P-E-S-T-E-R. And again, an internationally renowned literature term for the influence of kids in purchase decisions. Not only chocolates, kids now involved in very high decisions also. They decide which model of phone should the parent own. They decide which TV should be bought. This kind of decision are also now taken by kids. So product placements and this kind of nudges happen. The default options, as I told you. When you're given with a default option, most of the people go with the default. They don't ask what is the customization. Can I reduce the premium by something else? Or can I increase the security by something else? Many people don't ask these kind of questions. They go with the default. Number four, the Save More Tomorrow campaign, which I said that it is the Taylor's idea of increasing social security. It's a trademarked item. It's a very beautiful item wherein you increase or influence people to invest by small amounts and ensure social security. Then another nudge, the calories or sugar counts. if you are very much concerned about your diet, I'm not, if you can see me, you can know that I'm also obese. And so if you are very much concerned about your calories that you intake, the sugar content that you intake, the nudge is done in the packaging. Low calories, zero sugar, these kind of nudges makes you buy some products. So zero sugar is okay, but what is else than sugar? We are not, sometimes we are not thinking about it. So the calorie counts, the sugar counts, etc. there. Then the use of technology, that is the illumination lamps, the LED displays nudge you towards a particular product. The use of technology in the software pattern also nudge you towards a particular technology. We have many apps installed in our mobile phones. Do we use all each of them every day? Most of them are default options in technology. Once you update our phone software, there will be a good number of things attached to it, even though we don't want it. Okay. Then, displaying social trust. If you look for a hotel or a travel agent to book your tickets, and you see that it is top rated on TripAdvisor, there is a nudge. The ratings given to the products is a nudge. That is, top rated products are expected to be good products. There can be pseudo feedbacks, there can be fake feedbacks, but we don't know. But normally when you see a top rated product, you believe it. And that is where this nudge is happening in investments also. Because there will be investments like in mutual funds, there is Chrysalis rating or ranking the mutual fund schemes by rank 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And there are unranked funds. I normally ask my finance students to compare the returns of these ranked funds and check whether there is any significant difference in the long run or short run between these ranked funds. If there is, the ranking is good. If there is not, ranking is not good. There is something called as recently there was something called as ARQ scores. It had come in the market. It existed in the market for a very short term. In between, I wrote a few papers on ARQ. I verified whether ARQ actually works or not. And my finding was it is not working. And maybe similar findings were from other researchers also. This ARQ score was withdrawn. It was for mutual fund evaluation. Again, a nudge created. Then you will get SMS alerts. Frankly speaking, I have hidden my Facebook in my birthday in my Facebook. Simply for that, I want only those people who really remembers my birthday wish me. I don't want others to follow. But unfortunately, last birthday, my dear friend who regularly wishes me posted in a group so that the others also were aware of it and they also wished. But the SBI, the banks, the Reliance, the Jio, etc. are those people who will not forget you to wish you your birthday. Same way, SMS is used as a nudge to remind you. As a reminder that you have got this plan, you have got the bill due. These are nudges. Because these are not legal sometimes. OTP is legal, but the SMS led and a reminder is a service. It's an additional nudge for a favorable action because they want you to act on that. Favorably on that. But if the same way you get SMS that you have won 6,000 crores lottery, would you act on that? There are people acting on that and they fall prey for the spams or scams. So the fraudulent activity is happening. So nudges can be work negative also. Okay. This is one of those classical nudges happened in Amsterdam airport. In this airport, in the toilet, they found that people are not flushing after the use. It's a immense urinal. In that place, they found that the people are not flushing properly. So they stuck a plastic insect into the pot. You can see that insect there. It's a plastic one. So seeing this, after the use, everybody tried to flush. Automatically, the habit of flushing increased. That was a nudge they created through a plastic insect in a toilet. This is the food example that I said. The choice architecture, how can you structure your choice? This is the example with Google. You can see the two places taken. One is large, somebody like me, and the other is small. And what we say normally is, at Google, food is free. But then normally, if the foodies like me will be very happy so that we can eat everything what you want. But they will arrange the food in such a way that you will be nudged towards the salads first, which is healthy. And the unhealthy items, but which we really like more, like the fried ones, etc., might be kept only at the end. Personally speaking, I will directly go there and have my favorites. But through the research, they found that people had a healthy diet over a particular time, and their metabolism and their even energy levels increased, and work productivity also increased. So restructuring your food in the canteen creates productivity through nudging. How beautiful it is. This is in Stockholm Metro, underground passages. You have an elevator and you have staircases. In the staircase, they made a piano like an environment wherein when you tap on that, it will play music. So majority, instead of using elevators, used stairs. Using the stairs is always good for people like me and you who want to burn your calories. So to promote us, they created this music. And the kid inside us will always function. We will walk a lot. Instead of climbing once, you might climb more than once if you have time. And this was what happened in Stockholm and Hamburg. Hamburg, they created it like a marathon race court. As you can see, it's in a race court running field they created, so that you have a competition mind always. When you have a competition given to you, you will be happy to participate. Rather than a direct question, if I say, I have a question for you, and I have the next way, I have a competition for you. Some people are interested more when there is a small competition than a simple question. So like this, a small competition, and you are reminded regarding the importance of running or climbing a stair, you will be motivated to climb the stairs. This is what you do in Hamburg. So example. This is an example of a travel booking site, and almost all the highlighted ones are nudges. The most recent booking for this hotel was 10 minutes ago from Spain or whatever, which means it's a very busy site. You believe that it is a very busy site. There are 6 people looking at this hotel. So you believe that this hotel is a very busy hotel. The green colors item, the free cancellation, the reduced price, these kind of items are also nudges. You are anchored and pointed towards that prices. And this hotel is likely to be sell out soon. Again, you will be nudged to act fast because it is running short. A classic example in your cable TV, when you open in the direct marketing channel, they will sell you, it is running short, they will be running the bell and seeing that the stock is very short. Classical nudge may work or may not work, but people have a tendency. In a typical fish market, I am a person from, actually originally from Vaipan, where it's one of those seafood prone area. And where in our fish markets, normally that the people cry out is that it's going to end, it's going to close, it's going to close. That is Thiramona, Thiramona, Thiramona. That is the way that we cry. The sellers cry there. And that creates an instinct in the people to go there and see what is in stock. So this is again a nudge in daily life. Another nudge is created when you have a world map printed on a drinking water cabin, wherein you see that the world water level is getting down. So nudge towards not wasting water. A very simple nudge, not to waste water. This is another staircase where it is marked that if you are using the stair, climbing it, you are losing your kilocalories. The minus, minus, minus marks are there. So far, you will be happy to climb and knowing that your calories are burned. We are striving really hard to burn our calories, especially in the lockdown. So that kind of things happen. The nudge in the daily life also happen like this in elevators or sorry, escalators. You can walk in the escalator and stand. They divided it into two. If you want to walk, use the left side. If you want to stand, use the right side. Both is escalators, but still you can walk. And I also love walking on the escalator. It's a special mood. It creates a specific kind of energy than when you walk on an escalator. Because you are given a push from the back to walk when you're walking. So it's a very good experience and at least a minimum exercise. We will get a 40 to 50% exercise than the usual stairs. So that kind of things can also happen. People are promoting people to walk. This is again a promotion to use the staircase. It's actually a lifted door, but when you come there, you can see you are given the option that there is stairs available and stairs is better. So use the stairs as a normal message, another nudge. Another nudge shown in supermarkets. Yesterday, 120 people said no to using plastic bags. So the numbers matters. Even now, one of the nudge given by the government is a daily count of the COVID patients. We are afraid to see that the number climb. And we pray that we don't fall prey to it. And what happened, that's also nudging because the numbers matter. The numbers do matter. Okay. Then a classical nudge of electricity misusage. So once you use electricity, it is emitting carbon dioxide. Is it true? So we are using water for generating electricity. Why are they saying that? We are not only using water-based electricity. We are also using thermal plants. Wherein fuel is burned. And this is the example of that. A nudge in the normal buying platform, when you try to upgrade your Google account or you try to upgrade your any account in the internet, you will have this plan. You will have a pre-free plan. You will have a starter plan, you will have a basic plan, you will have an enterprise plan. And one of them will be highlighted as most popular. And you will be nudged towards the most popular. I am not saying 100%, but that is why it is most popular. Okay. Numerical anchors. I said, when you give that anchor, like the retail value is $400, now it is given for just $40 or $39.95. It's a numerical anchor. You are very much attracted to that particular price. You are given 90% discount. It's a very huge anchor. So these kind of numerical anchors also work in marketing. You can do research in this and how you react to these anchors. Because people react on a different angle. So to some anchors, they react, and to some anchors, they don't react. So you can find which are all the most successful anchors and which are not. This is another example of visual website optimizing. That is, in the first phase, they had a page, a Facebook liking page, or that kind of social media pages. In the second page, they removed it. So the add to cart improved. Was their finding. Because when there was a social media response page, people normally click on that. And it was the end of it. But when there is an option of add to cart or would like to buy at least, that in the favorite list, that clicking was increased. That is more likely to for a purchase or a business. It need not happen for all everyone, but still, these are statistics. Then nudge in the competition. Somebody tells you that I scored this much in this game. Try it. Same way, somebody is calling you that I want this much rupees in playing Rummy, and let us play Rummy. And I know we understand that there is a legal suits against that advertisements because they are promoting gambling. They are looting money also. So that kind of issues can happen. Whether it is legal or illegal, we have to question. There are laws of the land. We cannot promote gambling always. Of course, we do run lotteries, but we cannot promote gambling always. So nudges in daily life are part of commercial nudges also. For example, for insurance payment protection, you have to be nudged to get an insurance. It may be of tax benefit, it may be of the kids' protection, it may be of the family protection, it may be of the health insurance, anything. Unless you are positively nudged, you will not be taking an insurance. Otherwise, that is compulsion. For example, the group insurance scheme, the state life insurance scheme subscribed by the government employees of Kerala is not opted by our own. Your salary will not be processed without that. So we opt for it. But in fact, numerically, a state life insurance is remunerative than a life insurance corporation. Numerically. Still, people don't invest much in state life insurance. But there are conventional people, I know very conventional people who invest more in state products. Then, special offers. When you're given with too much special offers, too much incentives, incentivizing, that rushes. Then, pushy salespeople. The salespeople will give you, this will match on you perfectly. And he or she puts on a sari and says to you, and how can you resist if you have money with you? Even if you have planned to buy only one piece of it, sometimes you may be ending up with buy more than five. That is the quality of a pushy salespeople. Then special offers in mortgage deals. You will get home loan advantages. You will get top up advantages. You will get free transaction, lower interest. These are all special over mortgage deals. We are flooded with commercial nudges. We are flooded. This is not an exhaustive list. I am just giving you the insight so that you can do research. Please find these areas and do more and more research. So nudging in daily life, let us evaluate. How should it be? There is a difference between nudging and compelling. A good nudge may be considered which encourages a certain choices, but not pushing. Unwanted pushing Allah. The choice should be transparent. We should not be hiding the option from the other party. That is cheating. We should not be hiding. Second, the choice remains. You have three choices, but I'm telling you the second choice is better. Third, you have a good reason to believe that the nudge is warranted. When it is 5-star rated, you believe that it is good. And nudges may not always be enough. To reduce smoking rates, we need laws also. And that is why in our country, we have better laws to reduce the smoking rate and etc. These are research inputs for you. For those who want to do more research on this area, you can find Mindspace Framework by Dolin in 2012. It's a beautiful research area. Please go through it for your research projects. There are nudges in daily life given by Sunstein in 2014. Like all those areas which I discussed, that is the default rules, simplification, use of the social norms, increasing the ease and convenience, this more disclosure, warnings or graphics, that is you are not supposed to do that like that, then pre-commitment strategies, reminding letters or reminders, eliciting implementation intentions, and informing people of the nature and consequences of their past choices. You can say that your choice performed worse, so you should choose better next time. That kind of nudge is also there. This is called as smart disclosure in US or My Data Project in UK. These kind of things are the nudges happening in our daily lives, and these are what we really learn from our exposure. So these are the points that I wanted to discuss with you. And if you have any questions, please raise it. I will try to answer to my level best. And thank you for your patient listening, and thank you, organizers.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Wonderful speech, sir. I hope all the participants have got all the information. Thank you, Samineet, sir. And now I welcome Ms. Hasna. Before that, I request all the participants, if you have any queries, you can ask in chat box. It's a time for giving the queries. You can make ensure that you can ensure that queries can be made in our chat box. The participants, if you have any doubts, you can raise questions in the chat box. Nobody is asking any questions.
Yeah, there are no more questions. Actually, in fact, it's a learning experience. They can learn by them now more.
Yeah, of course, yes, sir. So next session will be the vote of thanks will be given by Ms. Hasna KP, Assistant Professor, Sahya Arts and Science College. I welcome Ms. Hasna KP.
Ask me to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I hope you all got a wonderful, effective and informative session by attending our webinar. I, on behalf of management, principal and the entire team and crew of Sahya College, and on my own behalf, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to all participants for spending your valuable time and also sharing with us your findings and opinions today. A big thank you to Dr. Vineet sir for his efforts towards our topic, Nudge in Daily Life. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation for Dr. Vineet sir for his wonderful explanation on this topic. I may like to express our sincere thanks to our most energetic and supportive principal, Professor Thomas Matthew sir, for providing encouragement to move on with this webinar. I also wish to express staff of our college. Once again, we thank you for being with us this evening. Thank you. Thank you very much.